for the Saratoga Tree Nursery. And Dave, I was wondering if you could tell us a little bit about why you're interested in bringing the sheep to the nursery, and maybe a little bit about what we've done trying to manage this Phragmites stand in the past.
Sure. This is actually a unique opportunity for the nursery. With Gary's sheep here, we're able to bring them into an area which we, in the past, we have treated both mechanically with mowers and also with pesticides. And as you can see, it comes back every year. So the expense associated with that may in the future be able to be lessened by having projects just like this, have the sheep come in, they eat it, we're not sure what the final result is going to be. We might actually get better control at the end of this than we have been with the mowing and with the pesticides. And then for the nursery, on the nursery standpoint, who knows where this might extend to. We may be able to use the sheep to actually do some of the weeding out in the field. Because of this nice light-duty fence that Gary has introduced us to, we can actually run this exactly where we want the sheep to go in our growing fields and have them work in area, and then as the area, the control that we're looking for is achieved, we can move those fences and just move them to the next area. So who knows where this might take us, this study. So it's really a great opportunity for the state and especially for the nursery.
And Dr. Kleppel, I was interested to hear what your next steps are as far as further research.
Well, what we're interested in doing is actually taking the research and turning it into useful management for the state of New York. And so our goal is to, of course, continue gathering that area and trying to understand why herbivores make such good when they're distributed properly, why they make such good because but then, in addition to that, I'm hoping to work with a targeted grazing program for the state that would allow sheep and goats and other livestock to be used to target invasive species. To be used in, let's say, an integrated approach to and to do it in a way that actually restores rather than kills. We have enormous control with sheep. You have 244 different breeds of sheep to choose from that currently exist on this planet in domestic form, each adapted to a different kind of landscape. So there are sheep adapted to desert. There are sheep adapted to wetlands, as these are, these Romney sheep. There are sheep adapted to rough terrain, things like the Shetlands and Jacob sheep in the Icelandic. So you can sort of pick your sheep, pack the animals in type, and high density, let them love the landscape for a little while and then move home, and then rotate them around the food or small panels for 15 days. What you'll find is that the animals gently graze down what you are trying to get rid of. Species that you didn't know were there start popping up. Many of them are natives. And the animals are healthier because they're removed from their parasites. So they're actually benefiting. So just by mimicking nature, we actually turn our system from invasive species management to ecosystem-based restoration. And our studies with purple loosestrife, the plant actually shrunk